Hi guys, just want to make a message and talk to you again more about God's love. You know, yesterday I made a message where I tried to show that God is love, and the purpose of God, I mean purpose from us, God wants from us also to be walking love, you know. But then I realized why I removed the message, that most people don't know what God love is, what God's love is. You know, God is love, and that's true, but God's love always goes together with the truth. You know, God is also the truth. God is also a jealous God. God is also a holy God. God is a righteous God. And so God's love also is a jealous love, is a righteous love, is a true love. And, you know, God is also merciful. But thing is that, how to say, I tried to show you, those who didn't see the message yesterday, that God is love, and his ultimate goal for us is also to be love, but God's love. You know, I remind you that Jesus, who's the image of the Father, so if Father is love, then Jesus is the image of love. He walked here and he taught us to turn the other cheek, to pray for the enemy. But at the same time, God's love is not always being fluffy. He called Pharisees vipers, and he took a whip and cast out money changers from the temple. So God's love is always true and is just and is righteous, you know. So now, most people have no idea what God's love is, and even Christians, most of them from mega churches and those churchy people, they have no idea who God is and what his love is. So when I said that God's purpose for us is that we will be walking love, I meant that God's like God's love, you know, in his love. And his love will always guide you to truth, to righteousness, never into sin or unrighteousness. If you keep willfully sinning, you're going to hell. If you don't repent and die like this, you'll go to hell. Listen to me right now. Don't tell me you're under grace. You're not under grace. You're outside of Jesus Christ, and you're going to hell. Because if you don't obey his words, you are outside of Jesus Christ. And I tell you again, I remind you that before Jesus Christ, there was this mode called the Law and Prophets in Israel. And came Christ Jesus. He totally obeyed the law, he fulfilled the law, he did everything which law required perfectly, and he redeemed us from the law unto himself, provided that we believe in him. And because we believe in him, we believe that he is also the judge of the living and the dead, and that his words will judge us, like he said. And because we believe in that, we obey his words. If you don't obey his words, you don't believe he's the judge, and you don't believe in Jesus. That means that you'll go to hell, because Jesus said, the one who rejects me and doesn't accept my words, he has a judge. The words which I have spoken, I will judge him on the last days. So guys, God is love, but God's love is also true and just. And in Old Testament, you know, like Paul said, that love is fulfillment of the law. That's why when Christ came, he went to the mountain, you know, like Moses on the mountain gave the law, Christ also gave his new law of Christ on the mountain. And Christ's commandments in the four gospels, they supersede by far, by standard, they raise the bar, you know. He didn't just leave us like some maybe Christians, fake Christians think that, you know, grace means that, you know, you do whatever and God is okay with it. That's they have no idea who God is and what grace is. Grace, it means that you are justified by faith in Jesus Christ, and that means that you obey Jesus Christ, and that you are in your relationships with Jesus Christ, and you believe that he is who he said, the judge of the living and of the dead, and because of that you obey the gospel of Jesus Christ. You obey commandments, all Christ's commandments which he said. Now many people, you know, they so to say, look, Jesus' commandments, they raised the bar from Ten Commandments. And Ten Commandments was like, you shall not kill. Jesus said, even if you are angry with a brother for no reason, you're already in danger of judgment. And Ten Commandments was, thou shall not commit adultery. Jesus said that even if you look at a woman with lust, you already committed adultery with her in your heart. Law said that you will not lie, you know, and Jesus said that for every idle word we will give account on the day of judgment. So you see how the bar is, he's exact and the bar is higher, you see. So Jesus didn't just, you know, leave us with no law, he gave his words, which are now law to us, the gospel, and we will be judged not by Torah, not by anything else, but by his words. He said, the who rejects me will has a or who doesn't accept my words, which means that also that maybe you're a Christian, but you don't live by the words of Christ. You don't accept those words. You don't live by them. He has a judge, the word which I have spoken, the same shall judge him on the last day. So we are to obey the words of Jesus, guys, and we'll be judged by them. And there are like commandments, you know, there are different commandments, like turn, like basic commandments, like not looking at a woman with lust, you know, not being angry even with a brother, and the rest of 10 commandments, if you just look at them, of course, Jesus doesn't guide you against any one of them. You know, Jesus doesn't, well, Jesus automatically, if you follow Jesus, you automatically will honor your mother and father. But Jesus even said that if you love anybody, your mother, father, more than Jesus, then you are not worthy of him. You know, you cannot love them more than Jesus. You cannot obey your parents more than Jesus. If Jesus tells you don't do something and parents say do something, you have to rather obey Jesus than parents, or else you cannot follow him, or else you'll go into hell. Also, you know, other commandments like thou shalt not steal, it's not even, you know, worth of discussing. Of course, if you follow Jesus and his Holy Spirit of love, of God's love living in you, this Holy Spirit of God's love will guide you into all truth. You know, love is fulfillment of the law. Love does no evil to neighbor, and love loves God also to the maximum, you know, every second of your life. So all God's 10 commandments, Jesus' commandments, do not go against any of them. There is a lot of debate about seventh commandment. Well, my point of it, that Jesus is our Sabbath, because Paul says in Colossians 2:16 that Sabbaths, new moons, feasts, those were shadows of things to come, but the body is of Christ. So the essence is of Christ. So what he meant by that, you can grasp more with this example with the field. When Jesus was walking on the field, and on Sabbath, his disciples picked up wheat, and the Pharisees saw that, and they started condemning the disciples. Why are they doing this on Sabbath? And Jesus said to them that in the temple, priests on Sabbath profane Sabbath, but they are innocent because they are in the temple. They are blameless. So, and he said, here is the one who is greater than the temple. Jesus is greater than the temple. So if you are in him, if you entered his rest, that means really you repented, you stopped sinning, and you obey his words, and you entered into right relationship with him, then you enter his rest. Spiritually, you know, you rest from your own works, which includes sin. You don't do anything for yourself now. Now you're a slave to Christ. You're in the kingdom of God now, provided you really are. You are seeking every day what you should do, and you are sensitive to the guidance of Holy Spirit, who reminds you the words of Christ and who guides you to all truth. Because Jesus said to the disciples, follow me. He didn't just say, obey my commandments. He said that. That's automatically, if you are following Jesus, you obey his commandments. He also said, follow me. What follow me means? He said, follow me, I'll make you fishers of men. That means that you rest from your own works. You are not focused on Jesus and what he wants for you, what he wants you to do every day. You seek his kingdom every day. You need to seek it in prayer, willfully. Seek his kingdom and his righteousness first, every day. You do that every day. No, you deny yourself, your evil self. Pick up your cross and follow Jesus. I told yesterday that in this world there are two kinds of love. The selfishness, love to self, and love to God and to neighbor. So selfish love in the eyes of God is evil, you know. And most of the world works because of this love to self. But Jesus sends his Holy Spirit. And God is love, and Holy Spirit is also Holy Spirit of love and truth and righteousness. And if that Spirit indwells you, he also guides you into all truth and all love and all righteousness. And when I mean love, I mean unfeigned love, you know, righteous love, which guides you into all truth and righteousness. So if you obey that Holy Spirit, then you are not under law but under grace, if you really obey him. That means you're not living under flesh. You crucify your flesh daily. And when I yesterday said that I battle to enter into kingdom of God, I didn't mean that I keep willfully sinning, practicing willful sin. I didn't mean that. What I meant is that it's sometimes hard to me to be perfect, to, you know, to perfectly do all that Jesus tells me to do, how he tells me to do. Some I fall short, guys, and sometimes I need his mercy. Sometimes I go preach and say something wrong on the street, I distract it. Sometimes somebody says something to me and I can fall a little bit in the flesh and answer with anger or something like that. And I repent. As soon as I notice it, I repent of it immediately and confess it, you know. But I don't practice willful sin, neither any serious Christian. You know, a serious Christian can happen to stumble, you know, and to fall into willful sin. I since I followed Jesus, you know, once I understood once saved, always saved is wrong, and I understand I need to live holy, there were a few times which I, you know, fell, you know, into sins. I'm very ashamed of it. It was not many times, but few times, you know, and I'm very ashamed of it, and it was tragedy. And, you know, and I thank God that he had mercy on me and that he didn't, you know, that I didn't die in while I was in that sin. One of the incidents was a willful sin, but it was like I was very afraid. Another time, you know, I was, well, I don't want to discuss that guy. I want to remember that. But anyway, that was pretty long time ago. And, you know, the Bible is clear that if we transgress the commandments of Christ, the doctrine of Christ, we have neither Son nor the Father. And so if you willfully transgress his commandments, you go away from your salvation. You're with the devil. And if you die like that, you surely go to hell. So God's love and God's mercy right now works through us who are serious to the world, you know, to help them to repent, to help them to flee from judgment of God, because judgment is written, it's the words of Jesus Christ, which will judge everybody. So we encourage them to flee his wrath, to flee his anger, you know. And why I'm making this message, and also why I'm shouting on the streets like a wild man, you know, you probably saw me. It's because I tried to be more loving, so to say, to people, and more soft. And you know what? I left the field and I felt grief in my spirit. And I feel that's not what God wanted to say to those people. You know, it's written in the Bible that God is angry with the wicked every day. You know, the Bible says that God hates all workers of iniquity. And God loved, yeah, Bible says that God loved the world, really. What it means is this: God did an act of love towards that, towards the dying world, that he sent his Son to die on the cross to give you an opportunity to come to him, to obey him, to be cleansed and get saved if you obey, if you believe and obey him. But it doesn't mean that, you know, he just loves what the world is doing. This world will be burnt in fire, you know, that in Peter said that it will melt, you know, from his wrath, you know. So guys, I don't want your blood to be on my hands, and I don't want to be a hypocrite and say like there is no tender part of God. God is, you know, there is this part of God which is very tender, very gentle, very merciful, very beautiful and marvelous. But you have to get to that part, you know. First you have to cut out all wickedness, because Jesus, who's the image of love, the image of God, the Father, God is love, so Jesus is the image of love. Jesus hates sin. It's written in Hebrews 1:9. So true love hates sin. And if you keep sinning, God is jealous God. Love is jealous love. God, who is love, he is jealous. He will not share you with your sins and with Satan. You either with him or you go to hell with your Satan and sin. So make up your mind, make your choices. I urge you to make the right choice. Obey Jesus Christ and live. May Jesus bless you.